Welcome. My name is Juha Klemola, coming from Nokia Data Center Solution team. Today, I'm going to introduce our kind of latest submission to the foundation. This is giving a quick overview about the submission and the specification, and then we are sharing also the testing results in a NEPS lab about the seismic performance. With this kit, we targeted the NEPS Zone 4 criteria, and the target is to fulfill the hardest Zone 4 criteria with a single rack with 18 and 50 kilogram IT load inside. The origin of the requirement was that because we are selling the racks to the telco customers, and a lot of the facilities are located in seismic areas. You can see the global seismic hazard map, and a lot of the big cities are located seismic areas. In telco space, we don't have the luxury to select the data center place that is a kind of non-seismic area. The idea was the kind of design, kind of a bolt-on option to the OpenRack version 2. Because when the seismic features are not needed, so we can sell the rack without the kit. The approach is that we have a set of steel beams. There's vertical beams and diagonal beams in the front and back to make it tolerant to the seismic events, and especially the side-to-side stiffness of the rack frame was the problem. Otherwise, in a front to back, the OpenRack is already quite stiff. Part of the kit is naturally the mounting brackets to the data center floor. The design was targeting to be tool-less, so the diagonal beams can be removed just using the clevis pins, and this is kind of fulfilling then the kind of OCP principle, easy serviceability. Same kind of tool-less method is front side and rear side of the rack. About the kit, this is designed currently to 42 OpenU rack, and we have defined this kind of bolt pattern, so there's a set of the bolt holes in the rack frame that the kit is adapted. This kit can be easily modified to the different rack heights. If you are using different racks, you can take this 3D model of this kit and utilize that to fit your rack design. The floor mounting bracket was a kind of external, and that was designed for the fast installation in the data center. Once the bracket is in place, you can use the impact drill directly drilling through the floor mounting bracket and then install the floor anchoring. Before the installation, you don't need to make accurate measurements in a data center floor. So you just put the brackets on place and then drill the holes, and that's it. One year ago, I was in here, and I was presented this idea. But we done the kind of first testing, and after that, we realized we need to a little bit change the design. But now with this design, we have really the tested the thing to be working, and. We run the test in a NEPS lab, and there was a full there was server installation inside. So also our kind of servers and JBoards are fulfilling the seismic criteria, and total rack load in the testing was 2020 LBS, and of course this is kind of the typical installation, and if you have a kind of different installation, and if the rack is more top heavy, so of course need to ensure the seismic compliance. But this is quite an equal weight distribution, so the weight of the servers was the same in the top of the rack and bottom of the rack. So we make kind of a typical approach in the testing. And I can run. Now the maybe test video. So NTS lab, what we run this testing. Does it work? So first was the kind of the side to side, which was the kind of interesting in here. So what is happening? So the shaker table is running the vertex curve of the seismic, and it's quite violent event in totally. So running one direction, then we are changing the orientation of the rack. So the next will be the front to back shaking. And we are monitoring the kind of traffic through the servers during the test. So there was no single error during the test. So you can see in front to back there's a kind of, you cannot even see any movement. Side to side, there's a top of the rack, there's a slight movement still. And according to the standard NEPS test, there's a three axis, so X, Y, and Z. And Z is the last one, it's a kind of vertical shaking. And there's several criteria in NEPS testing. There's defined the displacement during testing, so top of the rack, the maximum allowed displacement is 3 inches. Then there's a kind of neutral frequency of the kind of mechanics tested as well, but typically there's no problem with that. Okay, that was it. Right, by the way, stop. I need to. So the design fulfilled NEPS physical and functional performance requirements without any problems. And here is the displacement, the measurement data. So there's seconds in horizontal axis and the displacement in vertical axis. And you can see that the maximum displacement is below 1.5 inches in every area, or 1.3 actually. And you can see also this data that front rear displacement is a little bit over 0.5 inch at maximum. Okay, we have published the draft specification and the 3D models of the design kit for the review. And behind this link, you can find the material. And we have this kit also visible in here. So Nokia booth B6, you're welcome to visit and see the kit. The floor mounting brackets, we are not having those in here, but otherwise the kit is in the place. And we are in a progress to get it approval for the kit and for the next incubation team meeting, we are targeting to have that on our agenda. And targeting to have also in a later in a OCP marketplace available. Okay, thank you. So that was kind of brief introduction for the specification and the kit. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Juha. Very interesting.
Okay.
Just one question, or a couple of questions actually. First one, have you done any multi-axis testing, so all three axes at once to truly replicate a seismic event?
Yeah, that I'm not aware of that kind of test specification at all. So because we have done at least whole my career already 20 years ago, we've done first kind of seismic racks, and but always we have using this kind of shaker that one axis at a time, and also the NEPS specifies that testing method that way. Do you know any that kind of specification?
Interesting. I just in the past we've done three axes at once, and obviously it's a lot more severe, but NEPS I know is
yeah, but of course, what kind of shaker actually it is that can perform three axes at the same time? So
yeah, it's a big one. Yeah, yeah. There's not many around.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah.
Okay.
Because okay, I have been seen in Japan and in the US and Europe, all the shakers are running one axis at the time.
Yeah, well, we've been used one in Japan before. And there's one in Bristol University they have in England. They have a three axes table.
Yeah,
is available. But.
And of course, one of the because the OCP rack is quite heavy to find a powerful enough shaker.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, sure. I mean, it's hard enough doing just the standard transportation.
Yeah.
Finding the shaker capable of that without getting too much feedback back into the shaker machine. But.
And this NEPS kind of specification is widely adopted by the telco users, so that's just a common requirement for, and especially in Japan, they are all the installation is seismic installations.
Yeah. All right, good. Another question, if I may. Sorry.
Yeah.
Have you done any further testing? You say the load is 916 kilograms or around 2,000 pounds. Have you done any further testing to see at what point, what load, maximum loading go to before the system sees a failure?
Yeah, we haven't done that yet. So that is kind of interesting to know. And also that could be one future topic. So how far we can go without any kind of seismic kit? Can we fulfill some server configuration to zone 2, for example? So that is definitely something to investigate more, but of course it needs time and money to do that again, the testing.
Yeah, I mean, it's a criteria at the moment. That's
So maybe that's a good idea, and we need to think about if we are, okay, busy times, so new project is coming, but try to find out if we have time to investigate more. That could be interesting. What is the kind of breaking point, how far you can go, and what is the kind of maximum server configuration you can fulfill for example, zone 2, because the, in many areas, the zone 2 is enough.
Yeah, sure. I've seen the kit on your stand, on the rack. It's good, nice and easy, snapped together. So that's great. I was just looking at the design of it and just wondering if you've done any analysis on the using a box section rather than a solid steel.
We started with the box section, and we end up breaking point. And it's our rack is a little bit higher, so we have one open U more than, for example, Facebook has, and the weight is quite heavy, and but of course now there's enough material, let's say that way. Maybe there's a, if you are thinking less weight, you can maybe optimize the material, but now it's the kit is surely fulfilling the criteria. Okay.
All right, thank you.
Any other questions? Okay. Thanks.